ferrous material. As we have discussed in theory, while performing this test, we have to magnetize the component and we have to apply the inspection medium. To magnetize the specimen under inspection, I am going to use circular magnetization method. And as an inspection medium, I am going to use finely powdered ferromagnetic powder. To perform this experiment, we have to use magnaflux tester. So let's get acquainted with magnaflux tester first. Magnaflux tester consists of two probes with which we can pass the current through the specimen under inspection. Here we are having the on-off switch for the magnaflux tester, and with the help of this probe we can adjust the type of current, that is AC or DC. Then this regulator we use to adjust the magnetization. So most commonly we put this probe either at 4 or either at 5. Let's see how to perform this magnaflux test. So first of all, I am going to switch on my machine in a DC mode. This is the specimen which is under inspection. We have to identify whether the defect is present or absent in a given specimen. So first of all, I am going to apply the inspection medium. While applying inspection medium, I will make sure that whether this inspection medium is applied uniformly or not. So here I am applying finely powdered ferromagnetic material uniformly on the entire surface. After applying the inspection medium, next step is we have to take the probes and we have to keep these probes onto the specimen. While keeping the probes onto the specimen, we have to keep them in a line. We have to make sure that the probes are perfectly perpendicular to the specimen surface. If you hold the probes like this or this, it will create a gap between the probe tip and the specimen surface. If there is a gap, when we'll pass the current, in that gap the electron will collide and it will create a spark, and we have to avoid the sparking while performing this test. So I have kept these probes onto the specimen surface, perfectly perpendicular to the specimen surface. I have applied a light pressure because of which the probe will be in close contact with the specimen, and now I am going to press the button to pass the current. That when we have passed current, the inspection medium arranges itself in a specific region. It means the crack is present in that particular region. After finding the presence of flaw, the last and most important step is we have to demagnetize the component. So let's see how to demagnetize the given specimen after the magnaflux inspection. While magnetizing the component, I have kept this probe onto the left hand side and this probe onto the right hand side. Now while demagnetizing the component, I am going to exchange the position of this probe. Again, I am going to put my probes at the same location and I am going to pass the current. So this is the procedure of demagnetization of the component.